Okay, what we're using is a 3/16 Lexan, clear Lexan, really high durable. And basically, what you want to make sure is that all the area around the table is really clean. And we're going to start out by just double checking, because you don't want dirt and lint. That's one thing you don't want. All right, so then we're just going to remove the protective coating. Now, if you remove the protective coating and you don't expose it to anything, you really don't need to clean that surface at all. If you had a piece laying around, I would recommend using alcohol to clean the surface first. But in this case, we're not gonna need anything. So now that is a tack rag, and that's basically just gonna collect the lint and dust from this surface, because I'm gonna lay that face down. And I'm using soap and water to spray the area really good. And then we can lay it down face down, and that's gonna kinda like stick it to itself, trying to help, you know, hold it in place a little bit. Make sure your hands are really clean. You don't want any oils or grease, so make sure you clean your hands before you do this attempt. We're gonna remove this backing and just really soak it well, saturate it. Again, this is just a soap and water, and this allows you to get a little bit of movement in place. Now this print is ever so slightly smaller than the piece of plastic, which is what you want. You don't want it hanging off the edge. So basically I'm just going to place it where I want it, and then we're going to squeegee it. Now the squeegee, you see I have a nice Velcro edge on there, which is a soft side, and it won't scratch the vinyl. So we're going to start in the center and just work your way out and get all the water out. Right now I'm just doing it lightly just to get it in position. I don't want it to move on me. But once I got it there, then I can progressively use a little more pressure and get it established. Then I'm just drying it off to make sure that, you know, I didn't miss any areas. So the next thing we're gonna have to do is back this with white, because that's clear. So if you were to just hold that up, you'd kind of just see right through it, and it wouldn't be very, wouldn't look very good. So now what we're using is a white translucent vinyl. On both sides it's clear white. Some of the vinyl has a gray pigment, but this is a white pigment, so you're gonna be able to see the colors through that. So basically the same process. We're gonna pull off the vinyl, soak the surface, and reapply again. I'm spraying it above it, trying not to let it touch anywhere. Spray the surface really good. Don't let it stick to your clothes, because you'll get lint all over that thing, and it'll be a nightmare. So once again, lay that on there. That's going to be ever so slightly smaller than the black. Same thing, light pressure in the center. And then I'm using the raw end of the squeegee, and now I'm going to start putting a lot more pressure on this. And you want some good lighting where you're working, so that you can see if you have any air bubbles. So, you know, you can look down the reflection of the panel and see if you have any spots. Try to get every air bubble you have. Well, you're not going to have air bubbles. You're going to have water bubble. Now, all of my products that I would sell that would go on a panel, like the side art and the control panel, you do not do wet. The only reason we're doing this wet is because this is a transparent vinyl, the clear. It has to be done this way. The other stuff is bubble free, and you do this all dry. And you can see in my other videos, I have the Miss Pac-Man restoration videos, you can see there me doing the steps of applying that dry. All right, now you have the protective coating that the panel came with. We're going to remove that next. And reveal. Now you have a nice deep look. This is just another option that I'm giving you guys rather than having a translit. Some people have requested for me to offer this product this way so it's not stuck to the front. You can see the nice gloss. Now I'm holding it up to the light so you can see the true colors of what it'll look like. So the colors are real rich and vibrant. And it basically looks like it was factory silkscreened. Thanks a lot, guys.